So what actually was said on that call? The White House released a rough transcript of it yesterday that shows President Trump repeatedly pushed Ukrainian leader Vladimir Zelensky to investigate Joe Biden and his son, Hunter. Now, political correspondent Sarah Murray breaks it all down.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
President Trump urged the Ukrainian president over and over to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden and his son, and he volunteered the help of the U.S. Justice Department to do it. There's a lot of talk about Biden's son, that Biden stopped the prosecution, and a lot of people want to find out about that. So whatever you can do with the attorney general would be great, Trump says in a July 25th call with Ukrainian President Vladimir Zelensky, according to the rough transcript released Wednesday by the White House. Biden went around bragging that he stopped the prosecution, so if you can look into it, it sounds horrible to me, Trump says. Zelensky responds, the next prosecutor general will be 100% my person. He or she will look into the situation, specifically to the company you mentioned. Trump insists there's nothing wrong with his request.
That call was perfect. It couldn't have been nicer. There was no pressure. The way you had that built up, that call, it was going to be the call from hell.
The phone call was perfect.
But the rough transcript provides the clearest evidence yet that Trump tried to use his position in the Oval Office and the weight of the Justice Department to go after his top political rival. Trump's call with Zelensky came as he and Rudy Giuliani were fixated on Biden's push to have a Ukrainian prosecutor who was widely seen as corrupt, ousted in 2016 when Biden was vice president. Trump and Giuliani claim Biden was protecting his son, Hunter, who served on the board of an energy company the Ukrainian prosecutor had previously investigated.
When Biden's son walks away with millions of dollars from Ukraine and he knows nothing, and they're paying him millions of dollars, that's corruption.
There's no evidence, though, that Joe or Hunter Biden did anything wrong. Roughly a week before Trump's call with Zelensky, Trump ordered a hold on hundreds of millions of dollars of military aid to Ukraine. On the call, Trump doesn't explicitly threaten to continue withholding the money in exchange for an investigation into the Bidens.
There was never any quid pro quo.
But the president does suggest the U.S. is getting a raw deal. The United States has been very, very good to Ukraine, Trump says. I wouldn't say that it's reciprocal necessarily, because things are happening that are not good. But the United States has been very, very good to Ukraine. Soon after, Zelensky brings up America's great support in the area of defense. That's when Trump tells Zelensky, I would like you to do us a favor, saying, our country has been through a lot and Ukraine knows a lot about it. I would like you to find out what happened with this whole situation with Ukraine. Trump then references CrowdStrike, the cybersecurity firm the Democratic National Committee hired to investigate after it was hacked in 2016. CrowdStrike publicly blamed the Russian government, as was confirmed by Robert Mueller's investigation. But both Trump and Giuliani have floated another conspiracy theory, that Ukraine invented the idea that Russia was meddling in the 2016 election.
Several people in Ukraine knew about a tremendous amount of collusion between Ukrainian officials and Hillary Clinton and the Democratic National Committee.
On the July call, Zelensky says the issue is an important one, and Trump vows to have Barr and Giuliani follow up with Zelensky. The Justice Department says Trump never asked Barr to contact Ukraine, and Barr has not communicated with Ukraine on this or any other subject. Giuliani, meanwhile, has already been in contact with Ukrainian officials.
Well, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi on Tuesday announced a formal impeachment inquiry into President Donald Trump ahead of the release of the rough transcript. Now, you can read the entire document at htv1.net.